To start, create two circles with a 6, 5 centimeter diameter, and secure the ends with copper wire. Sprinkle some water on the table. Now, let's begin our hexagonal weaving technique. For the first set of 3 bamboo strips, bend them at a 60 degree angle. The next 3 strips should be woven parallel to the previous 3, following the one over, one under rule. This will create a hexagonal pattern, and it's important to keep the tabletop flat. Repeat the same weaving pattern for the 3rd set of strips. If it gets confusing, you can refer to the video for the correct order. After completing each set, check to ensure that the one over, one under rule is followed. Once the 3rd set is done, you'll have 3 hexagonal patterns, and then move on to the 4th set. The horizontal strip in the 4th set should be woven on top to form a large hexagonal base. If the base starts to form a triangle, it means the positioning in the step is incorrect. After completing the 4th set, you'll have a large hexagon formed by 8 hexagonal patterns. Make sure the 2 opposite bamboo strips are of the same length, and check that each angle follows the one over, one under pattern. Then, lift each end of the strip from underneath. They should all be in the same direction and have only one focal point. Be careful not to lift the wrong strip. Especially pay attention to ensuring there is only one focal point when lifting, and not to create 2 focal points by accidentally hooking onto the main surface of another angle. Slip a ring over all the strips. Adjust it. Press the 2 bamboo strips in the banana direction above the ring to form a hexagonal pattern. Press the 2 parallel bamboo strips above the ring to form a pentagonal pattern. Next, form a hexagonal pattern. Alternate between a hexagonal pattern and a pentagonal pattern as you go around the circle. After completing one round, press them from underneath, which is now the outer layer. Then, hold all the outer layer strips. Gather the remaining inner layer strips together. Slip a ring over the inner layer strips. Adjust it and press downwards to make the hexagonal patterns the same size as the sacrum. Knead the strips, pressing them above the ring. Form a ring of hexagonal patterns between the 2 rings. When cooking noodles, it's important to keep them from drying out by sprinkling some water. To create an intricate weaving pattern, start by pressing the noodles upwards and weaving them in a loop. The bamboo noodles on the left will stay on the outer layer. As you continue, you'll reach the southern end where the weaving began, with the rightmost noodle pressed behind the 3 on the left. Following the pattern, pick up one noodle and press down 3. When there are only three noodles left, one of them has already been pressed down. So thread the rightmost main noodle through the one below it. Then, there will be only two noodles remaining. With the front two already pressed down, the rightmost bamboo noodle goes through the two noodles below it. And the last one goes through three cooked noodles. Sprinkle some chili flakes for added flavor. Once the weaving is complete, the table will have an upper and lower layer. Trim the upper layer to make the bamboo noodles shorter and secure them inside. Trim the lower layer to the position of the intersection point. Insert a copper wire into the hole in the middle of the bottom to make it easier to thread the rope later.
Thank you.